I am Ingrid Maida, curator and dress historian and manager of the Ryerson Fashion Research Collection. The archive has been in place at Ryerson as a separate entity since 1981. For many years, it was maintained as part of the library, and when I came on board in 2012, it had been left dormant. So when I got there, it basically looked like your granny's attic, and it was my job to bring it back to life. I look for items that fit within the collection mandate, which is to support diversity, heritage, and innovation. So students make an appointment and tell me what they would like to see. I bring those objects out for them into the other room, and they look at them and examine them. They also use the checklist from the dress detective to help guide their research. But I also encourage students to come in and just draw garments for inspiration and just to draw.
The first time I heard about it, I was very intrigued by it and very interested by it. And I was very excited to see all these different designers, but also time phases coming together. So when I actually came here and saw all these different items put together, I was really inspired that just one room can capture so many different stories, personalities, and different inspiration sources.
The online database is a relatively recent addition to allow additional access. Actually, anyone from around the world can enter a keyword into the search portal and see whether we have certain items in the collection.
In today's age, everything is so accessible through the internet, and we feel like we're taking in so much knowledge and information, but really you can't replicate the experience of touching an object and like seeing it. I would never be able to see these type of historic objects and pieces in the normal world, generally not going to museums to do research, but it's here at school, it's readily available, and again, it's just very natural, and you get to actually touch a piece of history opposed to just looking at it through a screen.
And even though I try to make as many images accessible online, to come and open a garment up and see what's inside, see the subtle signs of use and wear in that garment, how it maybe was altered or worn by someone else. Those are things you cannot tell from a photo, as beautiful as they might be. And I think there's something so poignant about holding the past in your hands.
For students, like I know a lot of young people, like some of these garments are older than a lot of us. So you kind of get to go into a time machine and see things how they were back then and like old techniques.
And I think the past is super relevant because without the past, we wouldn't be here right now. And I think all these garments in a way really inspire me to look deeper into subjects and meanings because there's so much more than what it just looks like.
Every dress tells a story, and uncovering the secrets of the dress is part of the experience of looking at an actual object from the past.